Hello everyone. We are here today to take you through the actual working of the workshop as it will be held during June. We have decided on certain dates in June, 2nd June to 12th June. We had already announced those dates when we advertised this workshop. So we will be talking today about the various things that go into actually running the workshop, and please do pay attention because it is important that you as workshop coordinators learn what actually happens during the workshop. How many of you have attended our workshops before? So I'm going to be walking you through the actual workshop procedure now. I have with me on stage Mrs. Jayashila Gaitonde, who's our senior accounts manager, Sajjan Dikshit, our senior technical manager who looks after AVIEW, and Abhilash, he looks after, he's our system administrator and will be in charge of the Moodle during the workshop. I'm going to start with a short history of the entire project because many of you are new, and I'd like you also to know why we are doing this whole exercise of calling you here and then, you know, calling all those teachers to various centers. I think it is very important for you all to understand the motive behind our exercise. So this is my outline. I will be giving a short introduction to the project and some history. We will be talking about the actual workshops, the methodology, the people, which is very important in relation to you, the people and the team at the remote centers. The coordinators workshop is already going on. Logistics for main workshop. We will be talking about AVIEW, Moodle, and what is expected of you all post main workshop. Jayashila Gaitonde will talk about the funds, and then we will be talking a bit in detail about some concerns that we have with our remote centers. This entire project was initiated in 2009 from IIT Bombay, and it was initiated mainly using EduSat in the first year, but you all know EduSat crashed, and then in 2010 we had to move on to AVIEW, which was a virtual classroom software which has been developed by Amrita University. We are in phase 2 now. In 2013, because of the success of the phase 1, ministry asked us to go into phase 2, trying to reach out to a larger number of teachers during every workshop. In the first phase, our target was about 600, 700 teachers at a time. Even that number is large enough when you consider the, the logistics that is necessary to bring together so many people. But we were asked to target 10,000 teachers at a time. So the second phase started in 2013, and IIT Kharagpur is our partner institute in this endeavor. We have conducted 21 workshops on various engineering topics so far since 2009. Our mandate was core engineering subjects, but we have also conducted some very interesting workshops, very popular workshops like FOSSI and solar photovoltaics, and writing effective conference papers, which we think touches every aspect of a teacher's life. I'm very proud to say that the workshops so far have been attended by over 85,000 participants, and we have a network of about 344 remote centers. This is our methodology. We identify institutes across the country which could act as remote centers. They normally we look for good institutes with a good reputation, good infrastructure, good faculty, and a large number of engineering disciplines, and the fact that they could host teachers from colleges around them. Now we come to the people at remote centers. You all know that you are workshop coordinators, you are teaching this particular subject in your institute, so you have been nominated by your institute heads to come here and get an orientation on the actual subject as it will be taught during the main workshop. We have also appointed remote center coordinators at each remote center. You are aware of that? All of you, yeah. So a remote center coordinator is the person who is in overall in charge of the entire workshop project in your institute. This is one of the most important factors in our project, AVIEW. It's the ICT framework which has been developed by Amrita University. And we use this exclusively to transmit and deliver live lectures from IIT Kharagpur as well as IIT Bombay. We will be using the Moodle extensively since this is a workshop. I mean, the mode is the distance mode. We have to have a lot of communication points. Since we are targeting an audience of 10,000, it is not always possible for each and every participant to be able to communicate to the teacher at IIT Bombay directly. So one of the methods that we have come up with is Moodle. We will be using this extensively. So please go back and familiarize yourself with the Moodle. Fourth, we will be communicating with you only on Moodle and not on email. So please check your Moodle every day at least twice. How many of you are familiar with Moodle? Those who are not, please do familiarize yourself. You all have been already given Moodle IDs when you registered, and when you were confirmed, your Moodle IDs were sent to you. So please do visit the Moodle site. We will be using it for online quizzes, for assignments, practice questions, just about everything. Now I will come to the logistics for the main workshop. Yeah, my team is distributing a document to you all which has a very detailed list of what is expected from a remote center coordinator and a workshop coordinator. Please go through it, and today and tomorrow, if you have any queries, I'll be very happy to answer them. So once you read the remote center coordinator and the workshop coordinator roles, I'd like to tell you more about what else is involved in the logistics. We will be advertising this workshop, but you all as workshop coordinators will also have to do your role in the advertisement. We will be sending you soft copies of the brochures. There is a budget head for printing them and distributing them in your local area. Please advertise as much as you can. It is one of your duties. Please don't forget that. As I said, we will be giving you soft copies of the brochures. If you like, you may add logos of your institutes on the brochure, but please make sure that the logo of IIT Bombay and IST does not disappear. There have been cases, but please do make sure that we are the hosts. We will have the online registration about 2 months in advance from the main workshop. April first week, we will start the online registration. So make sure your participants in your colleges and your areas know that. I'm stressing a lot on colleges in your local areas. The reason is we find that a lot of participants are your own internal candidates. This has been the case in the past. So since this project is aimed towards teachers in general, please don't be selfish, pass the word around and host your neighbors as well. Okay? We will send you a link for the seating capacity that you can offer in your colleges. Please make sure that you meet the deadline, because that will enable us to allot a certain number of participants to your institute. The participants will depend upon how many people you can seat. Also, please make sure that you have a computer lab with internet, because for Moodle, you need the internet, and time and again, we will be giving you fixed time schedule where the participants will be needed to go to the computer labs and use the Moodle. Coming back to the online registration, we will be asking the participants to provide a letter of approval from the head of the institute. Now, what is this letter of approval? The letter of approval says that the principal has given permission for that particular participant to attend this workshop, which means he is duty bound, he or she is duty bound to attend that workshop for 10 days. The principal has given the permission. I will be talking about this in greater detail later on, but it will be your duty to check the letter of approval, and later on, please send it to us. We will be putting up a short list on the website as well as send it to you. We will be sending you all the communication details that are necessary for the participants, their email IDs, their phone numbers, etc. The selected participants are also asked to contact the workshop coordinators and the remote center coordinators. And if you can offer lodging and boarding for outstation participants, the link that we send you for seating, that will include a column on whether you can offer boarding and lodging and how many people can you accommodate. So that list will be there. There is a separate budget head for outstation participants. Now, just before the main workshop, we have a detailed timeline for all this. I will be sharing that with you a little later. There will be a rigorous testing for AVIEW. Sajjan will be writing to you, your institute head, and your remote center coordinators, all three of you, about the schedule. Now, we do understand that you'll have some problems on with days and things like that, but it's quite flexible schedule. So please make sure that you interact with him and change the date according to your convenience. But we will not pass any remote center without testing. If your remote center has not tested rigorously according, and satisfied Sajjan, then that remote center will not conduct the workshop. It is very logical. I'm not saying this out of any spite or anything. If your participants cannot hear the faculty from IIT Bombay or see the IIT Bombay faculty, do you think there will be a workshop in your center? What will the people do? Just have lunch and go back. So to avoid that, make sure that you have your AVIEW in place. We will be giving out Moodle IDs to the participants. It will be your job to communicate with the participants once you get their details to make sure that they, all of them, have their Moodle IDs. They have to click a certain link and that they have created their Moodle ID. We will send you soft copies of Creative Commons licenses and the permission slips. It's exactly the same procedure as we follow here. We will be recording. You also might be recording, so you definitely need permission from your participants. On the first day of the main workshop, you will have the registration procedure at your center. Normally, the workshop will begin at either 9 or 9:30, depends upon the faculty here. I think we've sort of decided on 9:30. So about half an hour prior to that, you can have your registration in place. We will be conducting the inaugural and valedictory functions from IIT Bombay. They will be delivered live to you. I do understand that dignitaries at your local centers might want to, you know, inaugurate the workshop or whatever, but please make sure that the timing doesn't clash with our inaugural. We will be sharing helplines with you. There will be people who will be answering the phone for problems connected to Moodle, problems connected to funds, problem connected to AVIEW connectivity, administrative problems, everything. So there will be helplines. We are here to hold your hands through the whole process. It's not as if you have to look at it, do it all on your own. We are here, we are partners in this. So as I said before, we will be conducting quizzes, solving assignments using Moodle. So your internet connectivity also should be strong. Now coming again to the main workshop, these are the dates that we have decided, 2nd to 12th June. The tentative schedule will be 9:30 to 5:30. Sometimes if the discussion is interesting, very often sessions go beyond 5:30. In such a situation, if there isn't a quiz or anything going on, you are free to stop at 5:30. We've had requests from remote areas where they have buses to take them to the city and things like that. But 5:30 is the deadline, not before that. So we will be mailing the schedule to the coordinators, and also it will be put up on our website and the Moodle. Post main workshop, you will have to give the participants the final assignment. The final assignment is a mandatory clause in this whole thing. Only 100% attendance and the final assignment and the quizzes, they have to attend all the quizzes. All these components together will make that person eligible for a certificate. Please remember that. I have people coming to me asking for certificates even if their participants have not fulfilled these conditions. You all agree that full attendance is mandatory? If they haven't attended the workshop, how can they get a participation certificate? We need participation. The participants will be given a final assignment at the end of the workshop. We do give them time. We give them an interval of about 2 weeks. And I think that is reasonable enough, 2 weeks for entire assignment. And we encourage you to make groups amongst the participants, so there is group activity. There will be individual activity as well as group activity, so you have to coordinate that. Post the main workshop, we will prepare that 2 week window that you get for the assignments will give us time to interact with you regarding participants' attendance, and it will also give us time to prepare their certificates. So we hope that within 2 weeks, provided everything is clear, we will be able to send you the certificates. Some faculty in the past have wanted to give certificates of excellence to some selected participants or selected remote centers. You could think about that if you like. If any center has performed, very well and things like that. As I said earlier, we publish everything that we generate, slides, assignments, quizzes, lecture videos, everything is available in the open source. So that is another thing that I cannot stress enough. Please remember the Creative Commons license and permission slip for that. Now, I'm going to talk about something serious. I know I haven't been very popular in these past 3 days. I've seen complaints on your faces about attendance. There is a reason for that. I have been with this project for 5 years, and we have been monitoring this particular situation very closely. Most important concern that we have with the remote centers is attendance. I'll be talking about that in detail. Administration at centers. You all are here as representatives of your institute, and you have been given a certain duty to fulfill. You are duty bound, you are obliged to fulfill that duty. But that doesn't always happen. I'll be talking more about that. Every workshop that we conduct, we give out responsibilities of remote center coordinators and workshop coordinators. Everything is spelled very clearly in that. Please follow that. And make sure you follow that, because there are some people who don't follow that. Utilization of funds, which Jaya will be talking about in more detail. There have been severe concerns with that as well. She will be talking about that. And I will be talking a little about AVIEW, but I hope Sajjan will also talk about it. So coming to the attendance part, I talked to you earlier about permission letter that they have to bring from their institute heads. The principal gives them permission, but calls them for invigilation and calls them for regular lectures and things like that. What do you do in such a situation? You have a person coming in, signing, going back again, coming for lunch, going back again. What would you do? As teachers, what do you do to your students?
I will contact my HOD and also principal of my institute.
Yeah, and please tell them that IIT Bombay has become very strict. Okay? There is a total lack of discipline. I mean, this whole workshop coordination is, looked upon like a, event management. The workshop coordinator has been given some money. He has lavish lunches, and generally there's a party atmosphere. Please remember, this is a serious academic exercise. Don't forget that. And it is up to you to set the, the atmosphere of the classroom. It is up to you. If you are casual, everybody else will be casual. We've also had cases of workshop coordinators missing completely from the entire 10-day duration. By the way, if anybody has questions about all these concerns, I have a whole bunch of documents, okay? I'm not just talking out of my hat. I have a document which has proof about all this. So we can meet over tea and things like that, and we can discuss if you have any questions about that. This is one issue I've already talked about. There is no advertising, and there is only internal participation. It is very easy, You just go back, we are going to have this workshop. You put up a notice, get a bunch of your friends to come and sit inside the classroom. Don't bother about advertising or anything. जब IIT के लोग आते हैं तो यू हैव अ फुल क्लासरूम. दैट इज हाउ द स्टोरी गोज. प्लीज लेट अस हैव सम सीरियसनेस टुवर्ड्स दिस एंटायर इश्यू. We also have been getting a lot of complaints from participants that the workshop coordinators do not, you know, handle our queries. What is the point of your coming here, attending this rigorous workshop for 5 days? If you have any queries, if you have any doubts, get them solved right now. You have 2 more months. Get them solved on the Moodle from the faculty concerned. But please remember, you are, you know, representing IIT Bombay there in your center, and participants should not feel that these people have gone to IIT and yet not learnt anything. Remember that you are representing IIT Bombay. You have undergone a rigorous workshop. Clarify your doubts if you have any. These are some of my concerns regarding attendance. I'd like to now show you some actual shots. If there is any likeness with your classroom or with your institute, please do remember that it is deliberate. I hope somebody here recognizes this classroom. How many people can you count there? This coordinator sent us an attendance for 83 participants and claimed funds for 83 participants. 10 days.
You can see for the 10 days.
Yes, yes. I would like to share with you all that Amrita has given us an excellent monitoring tool where we can look into each classroom and take pictures like this. And each photograph has a day, has a time stamp. So people will not be able to tell us, oh, that was tea break or that was before 9 o'clock or anything. We have such people tell such things. You know, coming from people. आपने तो टी ब्रेक में फोटो ली होगी. ऐसा नहीं होता है. दिस वॉज कोऑर्डिनेटर सेंटर्स अटेंडेंस फॉर 20 पार्टिसिपेंट्स. 33 पार्टिसिपेंट्स दीज वे स्टूडेंट्स. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस माई टीम कॉल्ड अप दोज पीपल. वी आस्क द कोऑर्डिनेटर टू गिव द फोन टू द पार्टिसिपेंट. द पार्टिसिपेंट कुडंट टेल अस हिज और हर नेम और ईमेल आईडी बिकॉज दे वर नॉट द जेन्युइन पार्टिसिपेंट्स एट ऑल. These were proxy participants. And we are talking about colleges, we are talking about teachers, we are talking about students. Is this what you are teaching your students to do? I rest my case. Okay, we've already talked about this, very low registration foundance above the remote centers. Assignments or quizzes are not done by participants on a timely basis. Involvement of workshop coordinators is very much essential. This was notified to you earlier that this will be one of your duties, so you cannot shirk this. AVIEW testing is not done on schedule. We have people coming to us with excuses.
Our camera does not cover all the classrooms, so but you should pass this information to the participants. Please be in the camera framing while we are taking the screenshots. They will be visible in the screenshots, so we can identify that the participants are there. If somebody is sitting there, somebody is sitting there, we cannot cover that.
I have an example of this. This is the way the camera was set in one of the remote centers. They have not published their video.
They are publishing the video. The problem with the camera goes in the standby mode. So there is a setting in the camera. We have a AV coordinator facility at your remote center. Whatever feed you will be transmitting to IIT Bombay, he can see top right of the corner of the screen that what video is going to IIT Bombay. If suddenly the camera goes in the standby mode, he move the camera and will show the actual participations or the video. But this is not correct technique. There is a setting in the camera. The standby mode should be go in the never mode. There are multiple seconds, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. But the AVIEW coordinator should set never there so that camera will not go in the standby mode.
By the way, there is a provision for an AVIEW coordinator in the budget, and most remote center coordinators have a AVIEW coordinator who will coordinate with Sajjan to set up all these settings that we are talking about. While you are not required to do AVIEW monitoring, you should be alert to the fact that your participants are not being seen on the screen if we decide to visit your institute remotely. You should be alert as to what is happening. Okay, we don't expect you to be an AVIEW technician, but definitely some alertness is required. You have to be present mentally as well. Now, this is another case of a classroom which has very poor lighting. Hardly anybody is visible. We cannot count people, or I don't even know what they are doing really. They are not even looking at the screen or anything. So it's just a make-do kind of arrangement, just to show on paper that, yeah, we are conducting this workshop. Let me tell you something else. We have a large team here, and we conduct surprise visits. And based on our surprise visits, we have disconnected remote centers, we have deactivated them, we are preparing a list of defaulting remote centers, and we will be supplying that list to AICTE and to MHRD as well. Because it's the mandate, it's the money that is being spent, so they definitely want a, you know, justification of that money being spent. So we do all these things. It's exactly like the university pattern where you have, you know, flying squads and things like that. So I'd like to stop here. I will be taking questions afterwards. I'd like to say a big thank you to MHRD, Government of India, Amrita, and Indian Society for Technical Education. That's the IST organization which will give you your certificates. And of course, all of you who are our partners in this entire project. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon and welcome to the presentation on financial support to RCs for the main workshop. The outline for the financial procedure is like this. IIT Bombay will transfer funds to remote centers. Remote centers will utilize the funds as per the guidelines provided, and remote centers will settle the funds and send final settlement to IIT Bombay. We will now begin with fund transfers. For fund transfers, we require bank details of all the remote centers. Most of our remote centers have already provided their details, so they need not provide them again unless there are any changes. However, the new centers will have to provide their bank details in this format: bank name, address of the bank, bank account number, bank account name, and IFSC code of the bank. The details have to be uploaded online on our NMEICT website. Please note that the bank account has to be the official bank account of your institute, and it should not be in any personal name. We will accept your bank details. We will consider them as authentic, and we will accept them without any liability on our part. We will start the fund transfers immediately after the registration is closed, and we will complete them before the main workshop starts. Funds will be transferred through NAFT, and we will update the fund transfer details on the website against each RC ID. The remote center coordinator and the institute head will have access to this field, and they will be able to view the fund transfers. Also, after we update the fund details on the website, an auto-generated mail will be sent to the remote center coordinator, workshop coordinator, and institute head, giving the details of the fund transfer. The RCs will then check their bank account for the amount credited, and they will acknowledge receipt online on the website. Now we come to the fund utilization. Funds are to be utilized strictly as per the budget heads and the utilization guidelines provided. Inter-head fund adjustments will not be permitted. This is the format of the budget sheet. The chart is self-explanatory. The budget is in two parts, a fixed cost and a variable cost. Under fixed cost, we have honorarium, miscellaneous expenses, and institute expenses. Also, there are columns which will show the RC entitlement for the fixed cost. Honorarium is provided to the team members of your remote center. Honorarium payments should be strictly by checks or bank transfers only. Cash payments is not allowed, because we have been receiving complaints that it is only shown on the paper that the honorarium is paid, and actually they're not getting the honorarium. So only if the honorarium is paid by checks or bank transfers, there are some proofs that the honorarium has been paid to the team members. A team member should not play more than one role and should not claim multiple types of remunerations except for RCC. If a remote center coordinator is an expert in that subject, he can act also as a workshop coordinator. In this case, the honorarium is clubbed to ₹20,000. The next subhead under fixed cost is the miscellaneous expenses budget. This is provided for the registration kits to be purchased for the participants, stationery, postage, printing, photocopy charges, chartered accountant fees, and other workshop related expenses. Institute expense budget, this is ₹10,000 for each remote center. This is given for the common facilities provided by your institute for the workshop, such as electricity, infrastructure, telephone, etc. This amount has to be transferred to the institute account. The next part of the budget is the variable cost. Under variable cost, we have food, accommodation, and travel reimbursement. All remote centers will have to arrange lunch and tea for their participants and also for their team members. Accommodation can be arranged for outstation participants if it is available at your center. Travel reimbursement is also for outstation participants. This is ₹1,000 for entire 10 days period. The criteria for TA reimbursement is that the distance between participants' place to the remote center has to be more than 100 kilometers one way. Each remote center will calculate their own variable cost depending on their actual number of participants. So the total workshop cost per remote center will be the fixed cost entitlement as shown in the budget sheet plus the actual variable cost. Now we come to the final settlement. This is post-workshop activity at the remote center. We will be sending the budget sheet, detailed utilization guidelines with do's and don'ts, and settlement document formats well in advance before the main workshop. There will be two main documents, utilization certificate and receipt and payment statement, along with some supporting annexures to receipt and payment statements. Both these documents, utilization certificate and receipt and payment, has to be printed on your institute letterhead and they have to be signed by both the coordinators. The final settlement has to be certified by a chartered accountant. CA certification is mandatory and it is our audit requirement. Proper documents with original bills have to be submitted within 1 month after the main workshop gets over. When we receive your final settlements, we will be checking the bills thoroughly at IIT Bombay. If we find any cash payment of honoraria, any bills that are not related to workshop, the payments will be disqualified and the final settlement will be incomplete. It will be sent back to the remote center. You'll have to rework on it and submit it again. Get it certified by your chartered accountant again. This time the CA fees will not be reimbursed by IIT Bombay. The certificates of remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator will be released only after the final settlement is complete. This is my accounts team and these are the contact details for fund related queries. These details are also available on the website. Thank you very much and my best wishes for the main workshop.
When your institutes were made remote centers, we got a letter from your institute head saying that you have all this infrastructure in place, you have this internet bandwidth, dedicated bandwidth. We have letters from each institute. So now there is no going back and saying we don't have this, we don't have that. If you don't have it, own up immediately and your participants can maybe shift it to another center. We don't want the participants to suffer in any way. Our entire endeavor is for the skill enhancement of the teachers. That is the most important thing. If your center cannot give them the experience that we visualize, please tell us right now and we can shift the participants who register in your institutes to other institutes. Please be honest about this. One thing I forgot to tell you is that we will close the main registration 10 days before the main workshop.
Would it be possible for you to say in strict words the limit for internal candidates or the limit per college? That is number one issue that comes to my mind. And regarding this attendance, whatever you have told, would it be possible for you to highlight this in the brochure so that we don't have to go and talk, do a lot of talking? So if it is made clear from the beginning, no attendance, no certificate, so that we don't make some enemies for rest of our lives where we are going to live.
We'll do that, but you will have to tell them upfront.
Tell them, but sometimes you know that you can be strict with us because we don't know you by face. But there I cannot be so strict.
Some
that is the practical thing.
Madam, some professors will be very senior to us. It becomes difficult sometimes to tell them to attend. That is a problem that many a times when I'll be arranging some workshops, right? So it has become a problem.
In that case, please let us know and we are partners. We will send a team to your institute.
Small suggestion is that before you send the brochure to our remote centers, if you can just keep word into the minds of the heads of the institution, we will be very grateful to you.
I will be calling up each principal, each head of the institute personally.
There is a provision for TA.
Yes.
He or she may be subject expert. So, is there any provision for them to get certificate, participation certificate?
Yes, we provide, not participation, we will give them a certificate helping us in the workshop.
Okay, thank you.
It's not a participation certificate.
Okay, thank you.
And also we have cases where a workshop coordinator is not only the coordinator, but also a TA. I don't know how that happens, but we have had cases. Okay, so but please remember one person, one role only, unless the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator is the same. Only there it is allowed, otherwise not.
Can we accept any branch of engineer, electronics, CT, EC,
as a
participant in the main workshop?
Yes.
Any faculty member?
Right? Yes, but not just for certification.
No, man.
Should be involved in the either in the past or in the present or future, they should be involved in EVS teaching.
Exactly, that is what I was saying, not just for certification. And also for this particular workshop, we will be allowing teachers from polytechnics and teachers of PG courses, science only. You can try to get participants from PG colleges. Yeah, masters. Teachers teaching master's courses, not postgraduate teachers teaching undergraduate courses.
Ma'am, you are saying PG colleges. It's a little bit unclear to me. Is this undergraduate college you mean?
Just colleges those teaching PG courses.
Postgraduate courses?
Yes.
Okay.
Colleges teaching PG courses, but the concerned participants, would be participant may not be teaching PG course. That is all right?
No. Teachers teaching PG courses only.
Only, yeah. The colleges have, but teachers.
See, for AICTE, it is these teachers who are considered on par with engineering college teachers.
Okay.
So that
okay.
is a mandate That's from AICTE.
All the branches participants, they are eligible for this course, madam. Engineering branches. All.
As Professor Nikhil pointed out, the participant should have either taught the course or should be teaching the course. This workshop is not only for certification.
Okay.
This is specifically meant for skill enhancement. So if that person is involved in EVS teaching, only then.
Okay, that means they must be teaching the first year because we are having the triple ES, energy, ecology, environment.
That is fine.
In first year. And in civil engineering, we are having that environmental engineering subject.
Fine.
So either they should be from civil engineering or this teaching first year.
Not necessarily from civil engineering only. Other colleges, there might be people from other disciplines
okay.
teaching the same courses. Yeah. Right. Energy also, yes.
You please mention it in the brochure.
Yes, we always mention it in the brochure.
From my own department, some of my senior colleagues, including the head of the department, he doesn't register. But on that day, he comes in and he says that I wish to, you know, see the proceedings. What to do with that?
Fine, let him see the proceedings.
So he can sit there? Without registration, we can allow somebody to sit there?
No funds to be spent on him.
Okay.
No certificates, no food.
And number two
No disturbing the other participants.
Yes.
See, the primary focus of the workshop is the participants who have registered and who are the legal participants of that workshop.
Correct.
So all these other external people, they shouldn't disturb.
Second,
and that includes students, that includes research scholars.
And the second thing is the same. Again, from my department, some people, some faculties register online. And I heard in that sometime it happens. And they come to me and they say, yaar kaam hai. मैं जाके फिर थोड़ी देर बाद आ जाऊँगा. एंड इन सम केसेस इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मैनेज दैट हु इज़ वेरी क्लोज टू मी बट फैकल्टी कोलिक ऑनलाइन रजिस्ट्रेशन. आई वुड हैव अ रजिस्ट्रेशन फॉर्म इट सेल्फ दैट देयर हैज़ टू बी मैंडेटरी समथिंग और समथिंग लाइक दैट सम वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट लैंग्वेज.
We do understand that people have, you know, emergencies and things like that. We do allow half a day's absence, but not more than that. That was another thing. We are talking about really the honor code here. You as workshop coordinator, if he is not there for that session, please mark him absent. See, we are going to be watching you. I have a big team. They're all sitting there with windows opens on their monitor. They monitor each and every center. I will mention it, but please make sure that you bring it to that person's notice also. See, this is the situation. I cannot help you. It is difficult for us to take an online attendance because you are there as our representative and you have the dynamics with them. We can't do it.
When the participants supposed to submit their NOCs?
They will submit it online to us.
Before the registration?
Before he or she is confirmed. We will check that and only then we will confirm them.
Teachers, ma'am, who are teaching PG courses like MBA, are they eligible for that?
What does MBA have to do with environmental studies?
So,
okay, as long as they can prove that their syllabus has environmental studies.
Is this course is for regular faculty or even contract faculty can join?
Contract faculty is fine, regular faculty is fine. But that person, I mean, we had this problem of, you know, people who have been appointed for a short time and then when the vacations come, they are taken off.
No. They are there for 2-3 years period.
No. Some people, like people who are appointed for a semester or two semesters, and the general practice is that during the vacation, they are laid off and then when the semester starts, they come back again. In that situation, we request that the principal gives a letter when they have to upload the permission letter saying that this person has been a contract faculty and that he or she will be coming back to the college. I require a letter like that.
That is not possible in the government institutions.
I can't help that. Yes, but he has worked earlier and then suppose he is working in an industry. Just, no, reappointment will be, at least that principal can give us some assurance. No. See, after working, if a person goes into industry and that industry person comes and attends a workshop meant for teachers, is that valid?
I have a suggestion. Final submission. We send a sheet to circulate to all the participants that what is the name to be printed on the certificate. So we can make one arrangement at the time of filling application form online that directly the name should be printed.
On the first day, you will be requested to get the participants to give the name that they wanted.
What I'm telling, at the time of filling application form, online application form.
You will be surprised they don't do it.
Okay, and
you know, after the workshop, we spent 2-3 months sending and resending certificates to people who have spelled their name wrong in the first place.
At the RCC workshop, we discussed that creative license form and license deed, it will be uploaded on the while filling application form.
Yes, we will do that.
Madam, I want to talk about the travel reimbursement. It is written there, participant should travel more than 100 kilometers.
This is only for outstation participants, not local travel.
Okay. But is the participant is living or traveling in between within 100 kilometers per day, then are you going to provide the local convenience?
No.
Madam, is there a quiz on Akash tablet which were taken in last 1.5 years?
We are thinking about that, but since the faculty hasn't used, we don't have any tablets left here. We would have liked to give a demonstration here, but since we don't have tablets left here, we couldn't do that. So, we'll let you know about that. Most colleges here are Akash centers.
Yes.
You all are aware of that? Okay. You're also aware that we have recently given you funds to improve your connectivity and things like that. So there should not be any complaints about the tablets not working or connectivity not being there in case we announce a Akash quiz. Okay. Professor Nikhil would like a show of hands on where the Akash quiz is possible. Akash centers.
No, either the Akash or if all your faculty members can go to the computer labs, you know, if it is all Akash or computer labs, if during the sessions, if we can have a quiz, like I give my lecture and in between I stop it for 5 minutes and you all take a multiple choice question quiz. In how many centers is that possible?
No, professor.
Because we are not the RC coordinators, remote center coordinator, we may not be able to say it right now at this moment. We have to discuss with the remote center coordinator.
You told that the teachers who are teaching in polytechnic colleges are eligible to attend the workshop, even if they are not teaching the PG course. Fine. And my question is that the teacher or faculty member who is having PhD degree in environmental studies and teaching in degree colleges like BSc Botany, so whether they are eligible or not.
Sir, if they are teaching UG courses, they are not eligible. But it is not something that I have devised. This is the rule that has come from AICT.
Polytechnic is also not UG classes.
Yes, but we are making a special case for polytechnics.
Okay.
We are making a special case for polytechnics.
Okay.
Because
okay.
they are not normally exposed to, you know, workshops of this kind. We are making a special case for polytechnics.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
If you think somebody is very interested and that person is not eligible, you can always get that person to at least sit through on at her own cost, at her or his own cost. If you have place in your classroom, that person can definitely come and sit. The only thing that I'm saying is that we will not give certificates to those people. And most important, don't forget that we release everything in open source. At the end of 3 months after the workshop, everything will be available on our website. All these lectures. Okay?
Yeah. Madam, a miscellaneous expense when we'll go to college for advertising or distributing the brochure, that bill should be reimbursed or that will not be reimbursed?
You'll have to post the brochures. You don't have to go there physically and give. We have provided for postage but not for local travel.
Postage will be reimbursed?
Yes.
Okay. Regarding institutional expenses, all the diet, exercise, shall we have to write in a bill?
You don't for have to send us any bills. The amount has to be transferred to your institute account.
No bills for institute expenses?
No.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
The transfer has to reflect in the bank.
Yes, yes, that has to be.
That will be automatically generated, no, madam. That will, otherwise, you cannot conduct. No?
Actually, this is a 10 days program, right? The main workshop will be for 10 days, that is from 2nd to 12th. As Sarah used to ask us now often whether we are human beings. Yes, of course, we are human beings. If in some case it happens to be I am absent for a day, then who should I assign to?
That is the reason we have created remote center coordinator's role also.
Okay.
So in case the workshop coordinator is not able to attend the workshop for a day, he should pass on the responsibility to the remote center coordinator. But you have to inform us well in advance that such a thing has happened. There can be an emergency where you cannot inform us in advance, but the remote center coordinator then has to inform us. In a case where the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator is the same person, then another senior TA should take on the responsibility for that day. Information through Moodle, information through email. Yeah, the budget sheet gives you, you know, how to appoint TAs. So there is one TA for 15 people, 15 participants. Okay, and then that is how the order moves. Thank you very much.